In today's session, we'll discuss about the cross-site scripting vulnerability. Cross-site scripting, also known as XSS, is a web security vulnerability that allows an attacker to compromise the interactions that users have with a vulnerable application. It allows an attacker to masquerade as a victim user to carry out any action that the user is able to perform and to access any of the user's data. If the victim user has privileged access within the application, then the attacker might be able to gain full control over all of the application's functionality and data. There are different types of cross-site scripting vulnerability are there. Mainly three different types of cross-site scripting vulnerability are there: reflected, stored, and DOM cross-site scripting. Reflected cross-site scripting. A reflected cross-site scripting vulnerability happens when the user input from a URL or post data is reflected on the page without being stored, thus allowing the attacker to inject malicious content. This means that an attacker has to send a crafted malicious URL or post from to the victim to insert the payload, and the victim should click the link. This kind of payload is also generally being caught by built-in cross-site scripting filters in user's browser like Chrome, Internet Explorer, or Edge. Stored cross-site scripting vulnerability. Stored cross-site scripting vulnerability happens when the payload is saved, for example, in a database, and then is executed when a user opens the page on the web application. Stored cross-site scripting is very dangerous for a number of reasons. The payload is not visible for the browser's cross-site scripting filter. Users might accidentally trigger the payload if they visit the affected page, while a crafted URL or specific form inputs would be required for exploiting reflected cross-site scripting. DOM-based cross-site scripting vulnerability. The DOM-based cross-site scripting vulnerability happens in the document object module, that means in DOM, instead of part of the HTML. Now I will show you the reflected cross-site scripting and stored cross-site scripting vulnerabilities. Now there is a web server is running in IP address 192.168.0.104. So now I am opening that particular web application which is running in the IP address 192.168.0.104, and under this I'm going to DVWA web application, that is damn vulnerable web application, and make the security as low. Now see, there is cross-site scripting vulnerability reflected and cross-site scripting vulnerability stored. Now first I will show you how cross-site scripting vulnerability reflected is what. So here it asks to insert your name. Suppose instead of name I am inserting some script. Script alert XSS stored, and then end the script, then submit. and see, it gives us a pop-up message which I put in the alert message. Now suppose I want to visit that particular page from any other system. So open Explorer, Windows Explorer, and open that particular web application which is running in the IP 192.168.0.104, and then DVWA, the user ID and password for this is admin and password. Then go to XSS reflected. So see, nothing will happen. So that means the script which is written in that particular system, it basically execute on that particular system. Now I'm writing the same script in cross-site scripting stored vulnerability. So give the name, suppose test, then message, suppose script, then alert. XSS stored, and then end the script. Then click on sign paste. So it also gives us the same pop-up message. But the thing is that this script is permanently stored inside the web application. So further, from any other system, whoever opened that particular page, he or she can able to see that pop-up messages. So let's try. Go to the XSS stored vulnerability page and see. It also gives us the message XSS stored. So the basic difference between XSS reflected and XSS stored is, in XSS reflected, it doesn't permanently store inside the web application, but in XSS stored, the malicious script permanently stored inside the web application. Now I'm showing you some malicious kind of JavaScript which we can use to infect a particular web application using the cross-site scripting vulnerability. So before that, I am reset the database, otherwise the previous JavaScript was stored inside the database. Now go to XSS stored page, and this is suppose a demo, and put the script. Then I want to redirect this particular page to any other web application or any other malicious web page. Document dot location is equals to http://. Suppose I want to redirect this page into demo dot testfire dot net. So its maximum length is occupied. So by inspecting the element, we can change the max length. So from 50, I make this 100. Now I can able to type the message. So now I can able to type the script. Now net. and then end script. Now sign guest book. So it's redirect to that particular web application. Now suppose I want to check what happened if any user open this particular malicious web page. So suppose this is our victim and it goes to that particular web application which is running in 192.168.0.104 and then DVWA and go to the page XSS stored and see it also redirected to that particular web application. So this way we can also redirect a particular web page to a malicious web page by which one can take the full access of the victim machine. Now I will show you how to inject an invisible iframe to connect with the victim machine. So go to the page XSS stored, that means where the cross-site scripting stored vulnerabilities exist. Suppose the name is test and I am putting an invisible iframe. Invisible malicious iframe. Iframe. SRC is equals to http://, then the IP address of the attacker machine. Now I need to check the IP address of the attacker machine. It's 192.168.0.101 and using the port was 81. And then put the height of the iframe. Suppose height is 0 because it's I want to make this invisible. Then wait. We need to increase the max length. With this 0 and then end the iframe tag. Now sign guest book. Okay, so now the malicious script is already injected inside the vulnerable web pages. Now we need to open the netcat listener to listen the connection from the victim machine. So to open the listen netcat connection, we need to use the command nc-lvp on port 81. So listening on port 81. Now suppose this is our victim machine and victim machine goes to that particular web application which is running on 192.168.0.104 and go to DVWA and go to that particular page where XSS stored vulnerability is present and the attacker injects some malicious script in terms of invisible iframe. Now check from the attacker machine. Now see 192.168.0.102, which is the IP address of the victim machine, inverse host lookup, well, unknown host, connect to 192.168.0.101, what is the IP address of the attacker machine from the IP address 192.168.0.102. So this way By using the cross-site scripting vulnerability, we can successfully able to establish the connection with the victim machine. Further, I will show you how to use the BEEF framework to penetrate inside the victim machine. And reset the database to delete all the entries. Now open the BEEF XSS framework. So username is beef and password is also beef. Now we use the hookup URL from this link. Now suppose this is our hookup URL. So inject this URL to the vulnerable web page. So go to XSS store page, and this is NPTEL. Now use the script and redirect to that particular malicious hookup URL. Document dot location is equals to we need to increase the max length again. Okay, now replace this localhost IP address by the IP address of the attacker machine, because we want to establish the connection with the attacker machine. So check the IP address ifconfig. It's 192.168.0.101. On port 3000, and then end the script. Now see, the page is redirected to that particular malicious hookup page. Now this web page is already infected. So suppose a victim go to that particular infected web page, then see what happened. Now it also redirect to that particular hookup pages and see in attacker machine in BEEF control panel, it show inside the online browser it's connect with that particular victim machine. It will connect with all the machine which access that particular web page. it also connected. Now suppose I'm showing you some attack which we can perform in the victim machine. Now see, all the details is here. Right, and cookies information is also there. So we can also get the cookies information. So by taking the cookies information, we can also perform session hijacking attack. Now log is here. You can also check the log, and then command. There is some attack is available from here. Using Metasploit framework, you can also take the access of the victim machine. I can show you some social engineering type of attack, right? Suppose we want to go petty theft. We need to put the IP address of the attacker machine. That's 192.168.0.101. Now execute. And now see. It's showing Facebook session timeout, so you need to put the email and password. letter@gmail.com password. Login. And now see. That credential is here. Email ID, exploiter@gmail.com, and password is pass1234. So this way, by using the BIF XSS framework, we can also connect with the victim machine by using cross-site scripting attack. And lots of other type of attack are also available in BIF framework. You need to explore all this kind of attack. Thank you.